Good morning, children. In the previous class, I had started the new chapter, that is matter around us pure? And we came to know that matter are of two different types, that is pure substances and the other one impure substance. Now, pure substances, that is divided into two different types, elements and compounds. I told you matter of two different types, that is pure and impure. Pure and impure. And pure is again divided into elements and compounds. Elements and compounds. Now, elements, today we are going to see, we have seen matter, we have seen pure and impure substances. Now, we will see elements. Elements, they are divided into three different types. Basically, they are divided into three different types: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Now let us know first of all what are metalloids. What are elements? Now let us first know what are elements. What are elements? Elements are substances which cannot be split into simpler substances by physical or chemical method. This thing I had told you. Example of elements: hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, sodium, potassium, gold, silver, aluminium. All these are examples of elements. Now, elements, they are divided into three different types, that is metals, non-metals and metalloids. About this you have studied in the previous classes also. Now let us know what are metals. Metals are first, they are elements. Each one is element. Metal is element. Non-metal is also element. What are metals? Metals are those elements. Those elements. Those elements which are good conductors. Which are good conductors. Good conductors of heat and electricity. Okay. Let us just see this metals here. Metals. They are good conductors. Metals are elements. Elements which are good conductors of heat and electricity. Good conductors of heat and electricity. Second, metals are elements which are good conductors of heat and electricity and malleable and ductile. Now first you should know what is malleable. Malleable word means malleable. Malleability is a property. Property, what type of property? You have seen aluminium foil. Now the elements which can be beaten into thin sheets, they can be made into thin sheets like foil. And this property of being beaten into thin sheets is called as malleability. Okay, so the property, what is this malleability? Metals are malleable, I said. Metals are elements which are good conductors of heat and electricity and they are malleable and ductile. So what is malleability? Malleability is that property of elements in which they can be beaten into thin sheets. Okay, now the second property, I said ductile. Ductile means what? Ductile means they can be converted into thin wires. You can see copper wire in electricity, electric wires. So, copper wire, gold wire, silver wires, everything you can see. So, those are metals. So, they can be made into thin wires. This property, the property of the element by which they can be made into thin wires is called as ductility. Got it? Now, malleability and ductility. Now, metals are good conductors, they are ductile, they are malleable, they are also sonorous. Now, what is sonorous means? Sonorous means when we beat them, they make sound. Sound which produces sound. Sonorous means which produces sound. So, they are sonorous. They are lustrous. Lustrous means they are having shine. Gold, aluminium foil, you know, it is very shiny. So, copper, it also shines. It has, each and every element has its own shine. So, they have such properties like they are good conductors, malleable, ductile, sonorous, lustrous. Let me write it. Malleable. Okay. Non-metals are just opposite to that. They are not good conductors. They are not malleable. They are not ductile. They are not sonorous. They are not lustrous. But in case of everyone, there is some or the other exceptions. Now, like metals are generally solid. You see, aluminium is solid, copper is solid, iron is solid. All these are solids. But in that, we have one element or one metal which is liquid. That is mercury. Mercury, which is used in thermometers, that is an exception. It is a metal which is liquid at normal temperature. So we have exceptions in this. Like I told you, non-metals are not good conductors. But you know, carbon in the form of graphite, it is a good conductor of electricity. So metals are generally hard substances, and non-metals are not very hard. They are brittle. Brittle means, you know, coal. You have seen coal. When you break it, what happens? It breaks into pieces. So this is brittle. Now, though it is the property of non-metal, carbon is a non-metal. Diamond, one of the form of carbon, it is the hardest substance known. So this way, there are exceptions in their properties also. You need to go through about this in your book, through your books. Now, I told you what are metals, I told you what are non-metals. Examples of metals, sodium, potassium. Sodium, potassium are the elements or the metals which are low in density, which have low melting point. They are very, very reactive, and so they are stored in kerosene. They are not, if we keep in the air or just bring out and keep it in the air, sodium, it will catch fire. In water, if you keep, magic will be there. That is, it will catch fire. Flame you can see. So it's not about magic, it's just about science. So since they are very reactive substances, they are stored in kerosene. Okay, so these are the properties of metals, and just opposite are the properties of non-metals, but they are having some exceptions, and you go through about this in the, from your book. What are metalloids? Metalloids are substances. Non-metals example are sulfur, phosphorus, carbon, oxygen. All these are your non-metals. Now coming to metalloids. What are metalloids? Metalloids are those elements which show the intermediate properties, which behaves as metal as well as non-metal. They show the intermediate properties of metals and non-metals. Means they sometimes behave as metal, and sometimes as they show the properties of both metals and non-metals. They are metalloids. They are intermediate. Now, example of that is boron. Example of metalloid. It is boron, silicon, germanium. These are some of the examples of metalloids. So this is all about metals and non-metals, non-metals and metalloids. Now, further about this point, that is matter, pure, impure substances, we will deal in the next class.